So let us start for today's session. Okay. So I will welcome you all to the NetMinion Solutions. And today we will be starting with our new batch, that is CCNP and Core. It would be 350401. Okay. So when we are talking about CCNP and Core examinations, we are aware about that in Cisco there are a couple of examinations which can be on the basis of entry, that when a person wanted to join in for the networking field and wanted to start their career with someone, that is the entry point. It is a bit like CCT, if you can able to understand in the Cisco certification exams perspective. Then the next part, if one wanted to opt, is associate level. In associate level, we have a couple of the things like CCNA. Okay. Earlier, there were multiple CCNA in the market, but now you guys are aware that there is only one CCNA in the market. And apart from that CCNA, we have CCNA DevNet. CCNA DevNet is for them who wanted to enhance their career in the programming language. Then there is something kind of specialist also, if you wanted to go for the specialization of for something. But if you talk about the general certification, we will move to the professional. In professional, CCNP part will come. So when we are talking about CCNP, it means we are talking about the professional examination and all of the CCNP which are available today after 24th of Feb 2020, these are lying into the professional certification. Then when you are moving further for the CCIE, maybe in that scenario, you will go to the expert examination. Now, that was the quick slide to make you understand about the Cisco career certification. Now, let me tell you why we are starting with CCNP and Core. Okay, if there is a question for you, why CCNP and Core? First thing, I will let you know from the technical perspective that why CCNP and Core is required for you all guys. When I am saying CCNP and Core certification, it means we are starting with 350401 certification, that is the Core examination from your Cisco. And whole you can see it, that it is implementation and operating Cisco Enterprise Network core technologies. Why we are saying it the core technologies, we will be covering it in today's class, do not worry. But pause, then let us understand what all CCNP stuff are available in the market for us. So one is the CCNP and Core, about which we were talking about. The rest certifications are known as concentration examinations, because these examinations are on the basis of maybe your routing skill. If you want to enhance, maybe if you wanted to go for the SD-WAN particular solution, you can go for the SD-WAN individually by 300415. Maybe if you wanted to go for Cisco Enterprise Network only, you can go for the Enterprise Network. Similarly, either you wanted to go for the automation, either you go for the wireless, either you go for the security, all of these concentration exams are possible, but the base is your core examination. When I am saying the base, what does it mean? It means the core examination is required to make yourself as CCNP certified. So for clearing out your complete CCNP, your core examination, plus one of your concentration exam need to be get cleared, then you will be known as a CCNP. Apart from that, okay, apart from to earn the CCNP enterprise, where you required to pass two examination, one is the core and one is the enterprise concentration exam of your choice. But if you wanted to go for CCIE, even this time, to go for CCIE level, you need not to go for the written examinations as people was doing it earlier in earlier days. For that also, if you are clearing the core examination of the CCNP, you are equivalent to the CCN written, and you can go directly to go book your lab and earn your CCIE level of qualification exam certification. So that is the value of Core. So let me depict the same in the pictorial way. If you see here in this picture, we are talking about that if you wanted to go for CCNP enterprise, you should be having CCNP and core examination. Apart from that, you may go for any of the concentration exam of your choice. So that was the one reason that why you want to go for the CCNP. Now, let me give you some more reasons that why you want to go for the CCNP, and in this pandemic situation, why one should learn the CCNP, why we are focusing that, okay, you learn the CCNP, you go for CCNP, you prepare yourself for CCNP. When I am saying the CCNP, just keep the CCNP apart from your mind, okay? So when you see the today's world, all of us are not going out of our home. Okay, this is the pandemic situation. By the way, I would like to say you all that please be safe, be in the home, okay, and wear mask and take all of the precautionary measures. Then when I am saying that you need to go for CCNP, what does that mean? So to go for CCNP or for CCNA or maybe for any of the certification from the Cisco, one thing is very much important to know, and that is that world is now today going towards the digital kind of stuff. Okay, everyone is going to the digitalization. So you take the name of any of the company, any of the service, maybe if you see the hospitalization, okay, so if you see the hospitals, you can see that there is the digital kind of stuff. You can find out the Wi-Fi, you can find out the LAN, you can find out the servers over there. Okay, you see any pharmaceutical service, any of the big organization, you take the name, you require digitalization. Okay, you go for the stocks company, you require the digitalization. Okay, you go for the transport companies, you require the digitalization. You go for n number of the service, the digitalization is required at this point of world, and this digitalization is going more and more and rapidly increasing in today's network. And when such kind of digitalization is going on the boom, okay, someone is required to support that particular network. Okay, when I am saying the network, network can be a small, network can be a bigger. It depends upon the size of your organization. Either it is a campus level, either it is enterprise level, either it is n number of the level. But there are some set of principles. I will say there are some set of principles, there are some set of rules which you need to learn when you need to go for such kind of hierarchical model. Once it need to be get scaled, you can scale it later on. But first, these principles you guys should be aware of. Let me give you an example to you, okay, so that you may have, you know, more sense about it. Maybe we have only two users in our organization, okay? So we can have a modem. Modem have maybe the four LAN ports, okay, and it is directly providing you the internet services. And such kind of small setup is all good for only two or maybe one level of, you know, one person of the organization. Let us say this organization is now growing, and growing so far, maybe you are having now 50 users. If you are having 50 users, you need to buy a switch. Okay, that is the mandate thing for you. Maybe you can have a one switch, or maybe you can have a two switch. It depends upon your information, or it depends upon your requirement. It depends upon your budget also. So that is the whole stuff. Like when you want to scale your business, you need to be aware how you are scaling your business. Now let us see. Okay, let us, you know, more put some more users into the previous organization. So let us say we have a couple of the more users over here. So this is something known as user zone. And when you have the users, you must have some kind of servers also. So let us say we have some of the servers also. This is known as server zone. To make the connectivity provided onto them, you required the switches. And let us say we have the switches. Okay. This particular hierarchical model can consist of three tier. The three tier of Cisco, known as you can have the core, you can have the distribution, and you can have the access layer. So when we are talking about the three tier, it means we are talking about the three level of architecture in our organization. Into our core layer, we are talking about the very core or mission critical devices like internet or MPLS, firewalls, load balancers, etc. In the distribution layer, we are talking about our main switches, which are handling the user traffic. And into our access layer, we are talking about the end services like your users, like your servers, which are falling out down. Now, when you create such kind of infrastructure in your environment, you are building up all of the stuff or all of the parameters in the particular chain or with the help of the particular principle that anyone can, you know, manage such kind of network. So let me go ahead and tell you again. So this is your maybe access layer. Okay. This is your access layer where your servers and where your users are in the place. Then on the top of that, there are some of the core switches. Okay. Some layer three switches. Then this is your distribution layer. This is your access layer. This is your distribution. On the top of it, there is your core layer. Into your core layer, you can have some of the firewalls. You can have some kind of IPS or IDS. You can have maybe WAF layer of the infrastructure. So these or maybe Arbor solution you can have. Okay. Now, what are those solutions? Why we require them in our environment? Why we are spending the money for it? That old question should be come into your mind when you need to support someone's network. And there's the need come for you guys, why you need to go for CCNP. Let me give you a very, you know, quick overview that what the CCNP exists for. Okay. Let me bring a very quick slide and let me give you the overview. So here, if you see, in the new CCNP Encore, we have total six sections. Over the slide, you will be able to see that these sections are divided as such, like some of them are of the 15% consuming the 15%. Some of them are having the 10%. Some of them having the 30% of weightage, 10%, 20%, 10%. These weightages are divided by Cisco itself. It is not by the way, this whole particular slide is taken from the Cisco public document, that is 350.401 documentation. Okay. Now let me bring you to all of the stuff one by one. When we are talking about our first section, that is containing the 50%, here you will be able to see that this particular section is having the 15% and this section is architecture. When we go to the architecture more, you will be able to see that into architecture, one should be understand about the fact how we need to design some kind of enterprise network. Like I was telling you, either you have the IPS, either you have the IDS, either you have the firewall. If you have the firewall, what kind of capability it has? It has layer 4 capability, layer 7 capabilities, attack signatures are there or no? Maybe you have the WAF solution, maybe you have the Arbor solution. What kind of solution you are having? So that is what we are talking into the section one, that means architecture. We are talking about the architectural view. Then if you see, we are talking about the designs of the WLAN. When you are saying about the enterprise network or maybe any of the network, world is moving toward the wireless, right? Even all of we are also using the wireless, maybe on the phone, maybe on the laptops, maybe on some other devices. But yes, we are moving towards the wireless. Cisco is very smart. Cisco have put everything into the new CCI so that the one who is managing the network, he should not be the engineer of routing and switching only. He or she should be having the all of the stuff which is required in today's network. Like you can see here, we are talking about the design and principle and of the enterprise network. Then we are talking about the wireless. Then you can see we are talking about the on cloud and on premises difference also. Like what is the difference between the CapEx, OpEx, why we require the on cloud, and if we want to migrate our service on cloud, what should be the hurdles and what should be the benefits, what should be the pros, what should be the cons, that all of the stuff we need to talk about. And then if you see the next 2 points are talking about SD-WAN and SD-access. So when we are talking about SD-WAN or SD-access, it means we are talking about SDN, software defining networks. We are moving towards that, all about the automation, all about the intent networking. Okay, all about that. You just go to the controller and make the command push, and it will be, you know, applicable, or it will be configured on all of your devices. So if you have the WAN solution, you will go for the SD-WAN. If you have the LAN solution, you will go for the SD-access. Then yes, QS will be come into the picture. Either it is for your wired or it is for your wireless. QS means how you are managing your network. Like if you have the 100 MB of the pipe, this 100 MB of the pipe is not sufficient for all of your applications. You need to divide your whole of this network application in such a manner that you are just classifying some of the application, that these are the most important rather than others, and the most important applications you are putting the marking over there, and you are just making the play with kind of, you know, policing or maybe queuing, such kind of stuff you are using in the QS, and you are making it that okay, this is my prioritized application and this is my least prioritized, and whatever the least prioritized is, that we can manage that if we have some kind of latency. But for the VIP applications or for the main applications or for the mission critical applications, we cannot opt for the maybe, you know, more utilization, more latency. Okay, in that case the QS will be coming to the picture, and all of the stuff is coming into your section one, that is the architecture. Okay, we will be talking about the software and hardware kind of stuff also. So that is all about your architecture way. When we are talking about architecture, it means we are covering our 15% of syllabus in CCNP. And we are not finished yet here. If we move to the section two, although it is 10%, but Cisco wanted to make us aware about the virtualization. When we are talking about the virtualization, what does it mean? Virtualization means like either you are using your hyperversion 1, either you are using hyperversion 2, you are using VMs in your environment, and you should be aware about the virtualization techniques. What are the VMs? You should be aware. What about the hypervisors? You should be aware. Either you are using hyperversion 1 or version 2 in your environment, you should be aware. What is the difference between them two? You should be aware. So all of this stuff Cisco wanted to know, to make you understand, and that is the reason why in section two you can say that is that consists of the total weightage of the examination 10%, and it is the virtualization technique. Okay, now let us move to the most weightage section, that is section three, and it consists of 30%. If you see it, it is infrastructure section, and it contains your layer two technologies, where you will be having STP, where you will be having maybe different stuff. Okay, it is having your layer three stuff, it is having your wireless stuff, it is having your IP services stuff. So all of these things resembles to you CCNP routing stuff. So all the CCNP routing is now put it over the section three, which contains the 30% of the total examination. Okay, now let us move to the section four, which again consists of the 10%, and it is known as network assurance. So when we are talking about network assurance, Network assurance means how one engineer can able to understand and able to manage his or her network reachability and what is the availability of your network. How it can be done? It can be done on the basis of maybe remote logging through your syslog servers. Maybe you are monitoring your network through the SNMP. Maybe you are using some kind of utility like ping, trace, or maybe some kind of debugs. Maybe you are converting, or maybe you are using some kind of IP SLAs. Maybe you are using some kind of automation through the RESTConf of the NetConf. Now, all of that kind of stuff contains in your network assurance, which is having the weightage of 10% of your total examination. And this section is known as network assurance. Let us talk about our section 5. Section 5 in the CCNP examination is dedicated for the security section. And security is most important aspect of any of the network. Okay, if you have some kind of environment where you are providing the network service, but you cannot provide the security of that particular environment, in that case you will not be able to, you know, if you will not be able to secure it, it means it is not all good. Okay, so in case of security, Cisco provide you all of the stuff for the security, either it is related to the WAN, either it is related to your wireless, either it is related to your automation. So if you are using some kind of REST APIs or something like that, you should be aware about how to secure your REST APIs. So that is whole stuff we will be covering into our section 5 that contains the security. Okay, now let us move to the section 6. Last but not least, this section is having the part of automation. Cisco also wanted to make you aware about all of the stuff regarding the automation, because world is moving towards the automation. So one network engineer is not like the legacy kind of stuff that, okay, I am the master in the routing, I am the master in the switching, I am the master in the wireless. No. One person should be master in the security. One person should have the knowledge of all of the stuff if you are running out a network. And here into the automation, we will be talking about a lot of stuff. We will be talking about RESTConf, NetConf, regarding the DNS center, EEM applet, maybe some kind of agent and agentless tools. Okay, let me show you an example. Okay, let me show you a quick example how we can, you know, move towards that. So before that, let me make it. Let me open a quick application. This application is known as automation. Postman. Okay. Through Postman, we will be connecting to the Cisco DevNet iOS XE router that is always on. Okay. Cisco has provided you some kind of routers over the cloud. Okay. And it is always on the sandbox. The name of this device is iOS XE management cisco.com. We can log in into this device through the HTTPS over the port number 9443 with the username developer, password Cisco 123, where second letter is 1 instead of I. Now, when we will use Postman, it means we are building the REST API. So we will be talking about the REST API into our course. Okay, do not worry if you are not aware about this. Then let me get you in shorty that you will be learning from level 0. Don't worry. You will be learning from level 0 to the level where you have all of the information about this new curriculum, which we are showing to you. So when I am talking about REST API, it means we are logging into the device through the HTTPS or HTTP, or you can say through the web kind of stuff. Okay, and when we are going to the device through the HTTP and HTTPS, we need to use some another application. Here in our scenario, we are using the Postman. So let us quickly check over the Postman that what we are doing. Here, if you see over the Postman, I am putting the same thing. I am putting the link over here. Okay, that I'm using HTTPS, whatever my device is, over the port number 9443. And here I am just building a query, which is using an protocol name as GET. GET means we are getting some information from this particular device. And when we see what kind of authentication we are using, you will be able to see that we are using the authentication that we were showing you into the slide. So you can see we are using the username developer, we are using the password Cisco 12345. If you don't aware about these all of the information, do not worry. Again, I am telling you, we will start it from the scratch. We will start it from level zero. Now, let me send this query. And you can see the request is getting sent it on. And I have the information of the device. If you guys will see, this information which we are watching out over here is in some another form, but do not worry. You can see that IP, what is the IP? I am able to see. What is the netmask? I am able to see. What is the name of the interface? I am able to see. What is the description? I am able to see. So on the real iOS XE device, through Postman, we are sending a like request, the GET request for fetching out the interface details. And this whole stuff is presented in the form, the language or the data structure which you are able to see over here is known as JSON. What is JSON? What is not? Again, we will be explaining it from level zero. Do not worry about anything. Okay. So such kind of stuff you need to learn into the automation part. Okay. So when you are going to the automation, you will be learning about this whole stuff. So these are your six levels, which I was talking about in the CCNP Encore examination. Okay. And we will be covering all of the stuff in your this particular curriculum. Okay, so let me proceed further for the exam overview. If you talk about the Cisco, if you wanted to go for the exam code is 350401, validity of course 3 years, no prerequisite required. You should not be the CCNA or something like that. Duration would be 120 minutes, and if you need to schedule this exam, you need to book it from the Pearson view. Again, the passing marks varies, maybe more than 830 or 850 would be good for you out of 1000. Okay, now if you talk about what NetMinion will provide you into this training, we will be providing you online live trainer who is the professional trainer. Okay, we will be with you during the whole training. We will be providing you all the lab guides. We will be providing you the recorded session videos. Then training mode would be the weekend basis. It means Saturday and Sunday as per the India timing. Okay. We will be having 2 hours per day, 4 hours per weekend. Total training duration would be 40 hours or so. Okay. It can be more than 40 hours. Then you will be getting the lab access over the NetMinion platform, and we will be using some of the free tools like the Postman to build out your RESTconf kind of language. Okay, and more other tools whenever required. Syllabus is whole what we are covering, 350 and 401, which is Cisco public documentation is providing you. Same I have shown you over the slide also, my previous slide, that what we will be gonna cover. Timing would be 12 p.m. IST, which is GST or maybe UTC plus 5:30. Okay. And our training fees is now just decrease from your 40K to the 21K only. Okay. It is into the INR. If you're looking for the USD fees, this is your USD fees. Okay. It may be looking to you that it is much more expensive, but as per the trainers, as per the quality, you will feel like that it is nothing. Okay, and when you are investing into your study, it will never lose.